First effect, which one it is completed? Pressure. Second one, what it is here? The temperature. So third one I am taking, which one here? The concentration. So based upon the concentration, we have to say either chemical equilibrium shifted toward the forward side or the chemical equilibrium shifted towards the backward side. Okay, so based upon the concentration, we can use these two terminologies, either shifting of forward, either shifting towards here the backward side. So first of all, I can explain with example. A plus B gives rise here the C plus D. So in this one, I am taking which one? A plus B or the reactants. Which are these are here? The reactants. C plus D are here the products. So whenever the reactants concentration is increases, reactant concentration is increases, the chemical equilibrium shifted to which side here? The compulsory, the forward reaction. On which side here? The forward reaction. Why the forward reaction? Already we know that one. In the forward reactions, reactant concentration decreases, product concentration is increases. So whenever we are taking here concentration effect, the reactant side concentration is increases, then the forward reaction should be takes place. If the product concentration is increases, if the product concentration is increases, which type of the reaction takes place here? The backward reaction takes place. Which reaction takes place here? The backward reaction takes place. Okay, based upon the reactant concentration, whenever the concentration increasing in the reactant side, forward reaction takes place. Next of all, whenever you are taking up to the product side, the concentration increases, then which type of the reaction occurs here? The backward reaction. Okay, so these are the mainly three effects, and also catalyst effect is also there. Catalyst effect has no special effect upon the chemical equilibrium. Okay, so that's why in this one I am not mentioned the catalyst. So once again I repeat, what is the definition here? If a chemical equilibrium is subjected to change in temperature, concentration, pressure, then the equilibrium of that reaction is shifted towards which one here? To nullify the change of effect. To nullify the change of effect. Nullify of the change of effect is nothing but just we can say it is the cancelling of the effect. It is the cancellant, total not the cancel. That means how much of it is increased, you have to cancel that increased part. Okay, so that side only the chemical equilibrium shift. So that says here the Leachert-Lear principle. So first effect, what it is here? The pressure effect. Pressure effect always depends upon here the volume. Volume is nothing but which one here? The number of molecules. Volume is nothing but which one here? Number of molecules. Whenever the number of molecule increases, always the chemical equilibrium is shifted towards which one here? The low pressure. That means which is favorable condition here? The low pressure is favorable condition. Whenever the volume is decreases, which is the favorable condition? High pressure is the favorable condition. Next of all, temperature effect. Whenever the temperature increases, endothermic is the favorable. Whenever the temperature is decreases, exothermic is the favorable. Next of all, concentration. Whenever the product concentration increases, backward reaction takes place. Whenever the reactant concentration increases, forward reaction takes place. So it is about the Leachert-Lear principle. It is important for the 8 marks question and as well as the IPE level and the Eamcet or NEET level. Okay. Next, I will explain two examples based upon the Leachert-Lear principle. Okay, so here I can take the first example, Haber's process. Haber's process is nothing but preparation of which one here? Ammonia. Preparation of ammonia, it may includes here the okay. So here example, before the example, according to Leachert-Lear principle, what are the important Leachert-Lear's principle? We need this information. Whenever volume increases, what is the favorable condition here? Low pressure. Whenever the low pressure, whenever the volume decreases, high pressure is favorable. It is the first effect. Second effect, whenever the temperature increases, it takes place here the endothermic. Next, whenever the temperature decreases, that is favorable for the exocyte. And the third one, what we are discussing about here, the concentration of reactants increases. Which type of the reaction takes place? Forward reaction. If the concentration of products increases, it takes place the backward reaction. It takes place which one here? The backward reaction. So now, based upon these three terminologies, I want to explain one example. It is nothing but preparation of ammonia. Preparation of which one here? The ammonia. So it will give us here the 2 moles of NH3. Okay. So for this one, I am not writing the exactly value of delta H. Why? Because it may nearly possess the compulsory the negative value. That means it is the endothermic, exothermic reaction. Nearly I am writing here the 92.5 kilojoules per mole. I am not writing the perfect value. Just approximately value I am taking here. Okay. So, but it is important. We need here the minus is nothing but endothermic or exothermic. Those are only essential. Okay. So, next for this one. First of all, what you have to discussing about which one here the pressure effect. Okay. So, for the pressure effect, I am taking which effect here the pressure effect. Okay. So, in the pressure effect, I am taking the forward reactions only. In the forward reaction, what it is here the N2 plus 3H2 gives rise here the 2NH3. Okay, for the pressure effect compulsory we have to depend upon which one here the volume. Volume is nothing but which one here the number of molecules. So here the number of molecules, how many here? 1. And here the number of molecules are 3. And here the number of molecules are 2. That means 4 molecules are converting into here the 2. 4 molecules are converting into here the 2. That means which one is it takes place here? The decrease in the volume. Okay. Which is taking place here? The decrease in the volume. Okay. So here should be the decrease in the volume. According to Leach-Ottlier principle, whenever the decrease in the volume takes place, which is the necessary here? The high pressure is favorable. Which pressure is favorable here? High pressure is favorable. So that's why for the Haber's process, for forward reaction, which one is the favorable here? The high pressure is favorable. Which pressure is favorable here? The high pressure is favorable. So nearly we can use here the 200 atmospheres to 500 atmosphere. Nearly how much of the pressure is used in this one? 200 atmospheres to 500 atmosphere. If we use the more the high pressure, in that situation there should be the reducing of the formation of the products. So that's why here we are using the what is the pressure? 200 atmospheric pressures to 500 atmospheric pressure. It is nothing but the high pressure also. Okay, so that means we are completed the pressure effect. Second effect, what we have to discuss here, the temperature. Second one, what it is here, the temperature effect. So temperature effect, I am writing only the shortcut, not the perfect. Okay, so temperature effect. In this temperature effect, the minus symbol, that means always here the heat evolving process, tells about which one? It tells about the exothermic. It tells about which one here? The exothermic reaction. Okay, so that means increasing of temperature. Which one here? The increasing of temperature. So for the exothermic temperature, we need what it is here? The low temperature. We need which one here? The low temperature.